the same design tattooed on the back of my hand, the 108-36-36 degree triangle of the Pythagorean, which in triplicate, in superimposition, is this, which is the Pythagorean pentad. I don't know if you see it, but you can see it here. I didn't illustrate it with a Sharpie marker. You can actually see the Pythagorean pentad. And the nexus of that pentad, where all life generates, are the five vertical pod arrays of the apple seeds, and how they're actually arrayed at the dead center of any apple. At the center of gravity, or the center of enormous mass, there is no gravity. At the center of Genesis and that which we enjoy, the apple, there is pure potential. A seed, of course, is pure potential. You know the difference between potentiality and actuality? This is why ignorant human beings and the Western existentialist philosophers, a seed fell out. Here we go. Perfect. Kind of fell out fortuitously right there. People will say, well, humans do have free will. Humans don't have free will. They argue back and forth. Western existentialists are not philosophers at all. Philosophia means the love of wisdom. This is pure potentiality. This is pure actuality. This is the product of force and motion, capillary action, photosynthesis, the absorption of water and minerals, and just like a human body, an apple, of course, is mostly water. Pure potential, pure actuality. Free will is this. That's actuality. Nobody has free will unless it's actualized. You know, some interesting lumber. We don't really usually make wooden things out of apple tree wood. But it makes a nice, pretty wood. I think I have something in this house made out of apple wood. This is genetically identical to the DNA. Just think about this for a second. The DNA of this little seed right here is genetically identical to an apple tree. The apple tree from which it came and which it would regenerate itself as a new apple tree. Right? But you can't get any lumber out of an apple seed, can you? No? You'll say, I need some apple tree lumber. You know, I need to make a special desk out of apple tree wood. It's like, well, here you go right here. It's genetically identical to an apple tree. Well, I can't get any wood out of that seed. This is so idiotic. I rolled my eyes at everybody talking about free will. Nobody has free will unless it's actualized. Actualization is fruition. Oh, look, a fruit. Actualization is fruition. Yeah, I know I just repeated that once again. I made countless videos, too, and done countless experiments myself, and everybody that's duplicated this experiment will attest to the fact that it's true that the seed exposure to a magnetic North Pole or magnetic South Pole has completely different results, and there's a reason for that. In the case of this apple, where the actual apple is fed nutrients and water, and Genesis right here, because it's fed from the tree, right? Right here at the top. The top is regeneration. Yeah? Top is regeneration. The bottom, where the apple swells, pointed towards the ground, right? Because the apple's hanging like this. The bottom of the South Pole is life and growth. The North Pole exposure versus South Pole exposure on my magnetic seed exposure experiments. Everybody, there's countless thousands of people that duplicated that. They didn't believe me. It's like, oh my God, I did it, and you're absolutely right. Once again, let's repeat that. Top is regeneration. The bottom is life and growth, respectively, the North Pole and the South Pole, right? Yeah. This is the torus of life. The torus is oblate. Why is the torus oblate? You see here, we actually have a different proportionality between one half of the apple and the bottom. Same with an egg. The reason for that is geomagnetic precession causes lag. Yeah, the extrapolation of the hyperboloid, because magnetism, by definition, is centrifugal force in motion, centrifugal divergence, okay? Right? It's decentration. That centrifugal force vector is a three-dimensional force vector. It necessitates lag be created because when you actually have a geomagnetic precessional force vector, it's also called the Lemoore frequency, you have lag. You see the perfect pentad at the center of an apple? The Pythagorean pentad, the 108-36-36. I didn't draw this perfectly. Of course, it's hard to use a Sharpie on a squishy, wet apple. Doesn't want to draw very well, but seeds are concentration, the nexus of all potential. The apple is decentration. Yeah. This is the product of increasing inertia and acceleration. The seed, the genesis of life. This is the product of centrifugal force and motion. The capillary action of the resultant force. Yes? Seeds turn into trees, and trees bear fruit, but the fruit of the fruit. Yeah? The apple is the fruit. Okay? You think this is the product of the tree. No, the fruit of the fruit is right here at the center of the apple, which sits at the center of the apex of the hyperboloid. Yeah? The hyperboloid of increasing inertia and acceleration towards true genesis. We think of this as genesis, but this is not genesis. This is genesis, not this. We enjoy this, but the tree only cares about this. Specifically, of course, an animal or a human would swallow the seed, and then it would, deposit the seed out of the back end of the animal, you know, someplace, maybe a few miles away, something like that. And the seed, of course, would make another tree, which, of course, give rise to more fruit, so the tree would propagate itself. Pure potential, pure actuality. Potential versus actual. Seeds are equal to potential. This is the actual apple. Because with one seed, theoretically, not theoretically, in actuality, but with one seed, I could have all the apples I want and all the trees that I want. Of course, it would take time. I would have to nourish it, but I could have all the apples and all the apple trees that I want just from one seed.